It's Connie with SimplySimpleStamping.com. I am back with another double feature video for you. Guys, today we're going to be using the Peaceful Poinsettia stamp set. Now, I want to point one thing out. I've got a really great Christmas card for you using that stamp set, but did you know that Peaceful Poinsettia can be used all year long? I'm going to create a very simple sympathy card using that exact same stamp set. We're going to make those stamp sets last all year long. So let's get started with our double feature today. So for our first feature in the double feature, we're going to create a traditional Christmas card. We're going to do that again, like I said, with the Peaceful Poinsettia. We're going to be using a lot of images for the Christmas card. This is going to be our focal image. We're going to let Christmas wishes be our sentiment. And then we'll use the May the Season Be Filled with Peace and this little holly bee for the inside of our card. So let me share with you the cardstock you need for our card today. Real red cardstock will be my card base, and I have that cut at 11 inches by 4 1/4 inches, scored at 5 1/2 inches, and then 3 pieces of whisper white. Two of them are the same. These are 3 3/4 by 5 inch, and then I also have a piece of whisper white, and this is 1 1/2 inches by 5 inches. I'm going to begin with the Call Me Clover ink pad, and I'm going to take our Christmas wishes, stamp that right there in the center of that whisper white. I'm going to take one of those 3 3/4 by 5, and this is going to be for the inside of our card. Let's stamp May this season be filled with peace. I'm now going to bring in the Memento Black ink pad. We're going to take that little holly berry, and let's put one up here at the top, and we're going to put one right here down along the other side. Let me set that aside for a moment, and we're now going to work on the front of our card. So there's that great big poinsettia focal image, inking that up there in the Memento Black. Now, I'm going to actually turn this sideways so that you can see. I'm going to begin by stamping the poinsettia, and I'm going to kind of center it from side to side, but you notice I'm not going all the way over to the edge, just like that. I'm going to ink it up again, and this time I'm going to rotate it so it's the opposite direction, and we're going to stamp it here on the other side, and here's what's kind of crazy. We're going to overlap those poinsettias. Kind of ugly, right? Well, don't worry. We're going to be covering that up. But first, we're going to do some coloring. So I'm going to be using the Call Me Clover Stampin' Blends combo, and then I'll be using the light real red. So let me share with you real quick what I'm going to do. I like to use the thin tip of my blends, and you can see I'm just going to color with the light on one side of the holly leaves. Doesn't matter which side, we're just gonna do that to give us some shading. Now there is a possibility some of these leaves might show, okay? Even though it's a poinsettia, I'm gonna go ahead and just color a little bit of it. Like I said, this is all gonna be covered up, but if any of it were to pop out, I want it to be green. We want it to look like a holly leaf. Remember with Stampin' Blends, you wanna cap that off as soon as you're done. All right, now I can come in with the Call Me Clover Dark, and we're going to color in the opposite side. Very simple. I'm not even gonna do any fancy blending. I just wanna have 2 tones to my holly leaves. So let me color all these in. I can now come in with that light red, and we're simply going to color in all of the holly berries. While I had my Stampin' Blends out, I colored the cardstock that's gonna go on the inside of our card. So that's all ready to go. We can now adhere that to the inside. We can adhere this one to the outside. Now to put our card together, we're going to bring in the triple banner punch, and I'm gonna slide in Christmas wishes as far as it will go. We're gonna punch that on both sides. I've added about 5 Stampin' Dimensionals to the back of that, but before I tear off the backing, I do wanna look and make sure none of that poinsettia is gonna show. So if I need to cover up any more with green, I have the opportunity. But you know what? Luck would have had it today that I didn't need any of those. So let's go ahead and take off our backings. And our Christmas card is done. Now I wanna share with you how to create a non-Christmas card. I'm gonna create a sympathy card with the same stamp set. So for my sympathy card, I'm going to use the kindness and compassion stamp set. I'm going to use the sending comforting hugs and then our sincere condolences. But I do want to bring in one more stamp from Peaceful Poinsettia. How about this little image right here? The cardstock is about the same. Pool party this time for my base. 11 inches by 4 1/4, scored at 5 1/2. My two pieces of Whisper White, 3 3/4 by 5 inch. I have a piece of Whisper White cardstock that is 3 3/4 inch by 1 5/8 inch. And then a piece of Basic Black that is 3 3/4 inch by 1 3/4. So you can see it just gives a nice little touch of that black. You're going to color with your blends the same way. I use the Pool Party Combo Pack, and then I use the Bermuda Bay Light, and that's what got my little berries. Kind of looks a little more like a pretty little flower, but I thought the Pool Party was very nice for a sympathy card. So I'm going to use the Pool Party ink pad and my Sending Comforting Hugs. We're going to stamp that right here in the center of our Whisper White cardstock. And now I can bring in my remaining Whisper White, and we'll stamp our sincere condolences right up here. I'm gonna bring in a little scratch paper for this because I probably will be stamping off the edge. So there's that wonderful little image. I'm gonna stamp once, stamp twice, and three times, just to kind of give a nice little image right there. All right, I've adhered the inside and the outside. Now it's time to work with our sentiment. Now, I didn't feel that a banner was very sympathetic, so we're gonna skip the banner on this one, and we are just going to add our sentiment right here in the center of that basic black. And instead of dimensionals, I'm just going to adhere that, and you can see I can just center that up right there, covering up those poinsettias. I've got a little pool party shimmer ribbon. I've got a glue dot right there on the back. I thought this would add just a nice touch to a sympathy card. We can add that just right there on the side. And there we have it, a double feature featuring one Christmas stamp set, but we were able to create a totally different look. You know what I love about Stampin' Up! Stamps? I really find that I can save money when it comes to my stamping. Why? Because that's not just a Christmas stamp set that gets put away at the end of the year. I love that I can pull that out and I can create any occasions stamp, just change the sentiment. It's all about that focal image. Love that about Stampin' Up! Stamps. Now, if you want to find out some more information about today's card, or perhaps you want to order that Peaceful Poinsettia, here's what you need to do. Just go to simplysimplestamping.com and just look for the November 8th, 2018 blog post. I'm going to have everything there for you, the measurements for both cards, lots of photos, so if you need to see a little bit more. But you can find all the information you need on today's card right there at simplysimplestamping.com. Thank you guys so much for being here and being a part of today's double feature. Make it a great day, and we'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye. Thank you.